Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangam University, India. Today's topic is 6th lecture of GA transform. Today, I'd like to explain how to estimate frequency response from poles and zeros of H over G, and how to estimate H over G from the peak and the valley frequencies. Then, poles and zeros of H over G and the frequency response. What kind of relationship they have? Okay. For example, H over G is given like this. Then the numerator and the denominator. From this, we can know numerator equals zero. We call this a zero point. And the denominator, this means this is a zero point. Okay? This equals zero means this is a pole point, like this. Then zero point means star frequency or valley in amplitude frequency response. And the pole represents past frequency or peak. And for example, like this. Here, this is 0, 0 point, 0, 0 point. This is represent 0. This means a valley, or stop frequency. Valley or stop frequency. Okay? And this is pole means peak. Peak, otherwise, this pass frequency. Okay. Therefore, it means zero means valleys in frequency response. Pole represent peak in frequency response. We know this. For example, H over G is given like this. Then here, how to estimate frequency response from this. Then from this, we have to know zero points representing valleys, and also pole point represent peaks. Zero means this equals zero denominator. Then from this, we can know here R equals 0.5 and omega equals zero. Here, 0 points. And the pole is this denominator equals zero. Therefore, from this, we can know R equals 0.2, omega equals pi. That means here, this is a zero point. Zero point. This is a pole point. Now here, pole point means here, omega equals pi. Okay. Then from this, now omega equals zero is a zero point value is here. And omega pi peak is here. Omega equals pi, some peak is here. And this is to be symmetric and with respect to pi, that we call this one. Therefore, the estimated frequency is barely to peak, like this. This is the estimated frequency response. Estimated frequency response. Then let's compare the real one. Real one means from there, we can start here. From here, amplitude of frequency spectrum means instead of G, we can substitute E to the power of J omega. Then from this, we can get this kind of frequency. This is a real one. This is a real frequency response one. Then you compare here. This is very similar. Very similar. Therefore, here, what we can say is this H over G is defined, assigned in the given. Then from this, we can estimate frequency response like this. Okay. And it's a little bit more complicated one. H over G equal like this. This is a denominator. This is denominator. This is a numerator here. From this, we want to know, or we want to estimate frequency response from this. And for this, we have to find zero points, zeros, which represent valleys, and also poles, which represent peaks. Then from this, zero means this term equal zero. Then from this, we can get four zeros and angle like this. And the pole means denominator equals zero. From this, also we can get four points for angles like here. Then from this one, from this, we can estimate, the frequency response. That means now here, zero. Now here, pi radian is zero is here, 1.25, 0 is here, minus 1.5, this is one of zero, so 0 point is here, 0 radian point here. And this is also 0, okay? Then here, pole is here, pole equal 2.38, 3 radian around, around this. This is pole is here, pole, and minus 2.3 around here, pole is here, 0.8 is around this, is 0.8 is some here, minus, this is minus 8.51, and plus this one. Then we can estimate frequency response from this now. Now here, okay, now here, zero to peak. Okay, oh no, this is peak equal to, I'm sorry, so 2.38 peak is here. This is peak, not this, okay, not this one. This. Then from this, go here, and the zero go here, and the peak, and the zero, peak, zero, and the peak, zero, right? Okay, this kind of, maybe I did this kind one, this kind. This kind of we can estimate the frequency, estimated frequency response like this. Then also, we need to compare the real one. Real means from this, we can start here. Then also, instead of g, we can substitute to exponential to the power of j omega. From that, plot this kind of real frequency response here. Then you can see here, almost the shape is almost the same one. The peak like this one, that's almost there. Like this, if we know this h over g, from this, we can estimate the frequency response. Of course, this is not accurate. Okay, so we can roughly estimate frequency response from this. And then, if we know the poles and the zeros, this poles frequency and the poles frequency and the zeros frequency, 0, 200 hertz, 400 hertz. We know this, from this, we can, then means like this. Now here, zero frequency. Now here, pole equal 100 and pole equal 100 and 300. This is a pole around here, pole, and 300 poles around poles here. And the zero is 0.200, 0.0, and also 400, zero like this. Therefore, we can estimate frequency responses like this. 0, 2, this one, this one, okay, maybe this is some estimated, now this is estimated frequency response, okay. Then here, from this, how to know H over G, how to know G, okay. On this, we need first F to omega convert. Then omega g 1, omega g 2, omega g 3, and the power 1, power 2. This. That means here you can get 0 like this. Then here. From this we can know the 0 point and the power point. If we know 0 point, power point, we can guess the this one. Now this is zero point here, power here. Now here also you see that this coefficient, this one, this affect the coefficient affect to the amplitude of frequency response. Just that they do not affect, they do not affect the frequency. The real one is like this. Then you can see here almost same frequency response here. Okay? Now this is amplitude is some different, but we can estimate the frequency response roughly. And also from this we can guess, we can estimate H over G like this. Okay, this is a MATLAB source code for your reference. This one, and another one, and also this one. From this, you can get the poles. This is zeros, and this is poles in G plane. This is a frequency response. Thank you so much for your watching. Today, I explained the meaning of poles of zeros in H of G, and from the poles and zeros, how to estimate frequency response H of omega, and also from frequencies of peaks and valleys, how to estimate H of G. I explained about this. Next topic is causality and stability considerations of H of G. Please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much.